Hi, I'm Kirsten Wise. I'm an extension specialist for field crop diseases at Purdue University, and I'm here in a North Carolina cornfield today to discuss a multi-state research project that's examining management practices for Aspergillus ear rot and Fusarium ear rot. Now, these are two ear rots that are very important, not only because they reduce yield, but each of them also produces a mycotoxin that reduces grain quality and can be harmful to both humans and livestock. Now, it's very important that we manage these diseases as best we can and the resulting mycotoxins. So we have some research that's funded by the USDA and involves Purdue University, North Carolina State University, Texas A&M University, and the University of Arkansas.
I'm Megan Sexton. I work with Dr. Heiniger and Dr. Carbone at NC State. I'm part of a larger project on mycotoxins. We've sampled corn and ear samples of Aspergillus flavus in the 2013 population, and the goal of our project is to develop a more sustainable biocontrol to combat aflatoxins.
Hi everyone, my name is Megan Meier and I am a master's student at NC State studying plant pathology with Dr. Ron Heiniger and Dr. Ignazio Carbone. Alright, so my research project, we're doing three trials. We're testing three different BT hybrids. We're testing fungicides in unison with biocontrols, and we are testing two biocontrols with different rates and timing for the reduction of mycotoxins in corn.
Hi, I'm Ron Heiniger with the Crop Science Department at North Carolina State University. In this field, we're doing some tests on some tools to try to control mycotoxins here. And one of those tools that we're primarily interested in this test is the use of fungicides. On top of these fungicides here is the use of a biocontrol product called Aflagard. Aflagard is actually a non-toxigenic strain of Aspergillus flavus that actually does not produce then the aflatoxin when it infects the corn.
In each state, we've designed research trials to examine the impact of hybrid resistance, fungicide applications, and applications of biocontrol to reduce the impact of Aspergillus and Fusarium ear rots. Our goal with these trials is to understand which management practices worked best in each region so we can create region-specific management programs for Aspergillus ear rot and aflatoxin and Fusarium ear rot and fumonisin.